Okay. Now we understood the structure of C program. How to write simple C programs? Simple C programs. So let me start writing with addition of two numbers. Okay. So here already, as per our discussion in the structure of C program, I have given the structure. Okay. Based upon that, I would like to write a simple C program for addition of two number, adding two numbers. Okay. Okay, friends. Now I have written a program for adding two numbers. Addition program. Addition program for two numbers. That is addition of two numbers. Addition of two numbers. Okay. A simple addition program has been written using C language. Okay. As per the discussion on structure of C program, I said that the usage of hash include file, that is include header file section. Why we are including the header file section? Okay. If you want to include the input and output header files or library files to our program, we are using the hash include stdio.h header file section. Okay. After that, already as per our discussion, I said that the usage of main function. Okay. So every C program must contain main. So that I have specified main. Okay. And as per our discussion, the open brace I have given here the declaration part. Okay. So every main function has the two parts. One is declaration part, another one is executable part. As per our discussion, here I have given a declaration part like int a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, and c. I have declared three variables in that I have given values, the constant values for a and b, and I have given c. Okay. So these are the variables, these are the integer variables. Okay. So here I have specified int. Okay. So why we are specifying int? What is called as int in declaration? Okay. So int is a data type. Here there are several data types are there. So this int is a basic data type or primary data type. There are several data types. In that, the primary data types. Okay. Any C beginner, C program beginner, you want to know the simple data types or primary data types. That is int, float, char. Okay. So he may know the integer, float, and character data types. Okay. So based upon these, there are several data types that are like that. Okay. String, long int. Okay. So there are several data types are there, but here we are having some primary data types like int, float, char, like that. Okay. So here we are specifying integer data type to specify the integer value, that is the numeric value. If anyone wants to specify the numeric value, then he must specify int data type. Okay. And if anyone wants to specify the real values, that is the numeric value with the fractional point, then he have to specify float. Okay. If anyone wants to specify character value, then he may specify char. Okay. If anyone wants to give values within string mode, then you can specify the string. Okay, so here instead of float char string, I have specified int. Okay, so int, I want to specify the numeric value, so that I have specified the data type as int. Okay, int, here a, b, c, these are the variables, and a and b are the constant variables. So because I have specified value for the variables a and b, okay, so a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20 and c. Okay, finally I have given a statement like that, c is equal to a plus b. This is the executable statement. It comes in executable part. Okay, so finally I have given a printf statement, okay, where the addition of two numbers is c. Okay, so here I have specified percent d because we are specifying the numeric value. In case of specifying float, then we have to specify f. In case of specifying string, we have to specify another. Okay, so here now we are specifying the integer value, so that I have specified percent d and c. So the result which is stored, the expression, the arithmetic expression a plus b is stored in c. Okay, now we are printing c. Okay, so the addition of two numbers, the two variables are stored in c. The result stores in c, and we are printing that c. Okay, so here a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20. It means that we will get 10 plus 20, 30. The 30 will be printed, assigned to c, and the result of 30 will be stored as a result in addition of two numbers. Okay, so in this way we are adding two numbers. Here there are two ways are there. Already I have assigned a value. It means that a and b are the constant values. So if many times if you want to compile the same program, we will get the same result. Okay, we will not get the different result. If any user wants to get the different results, okay, then he have to give the values. He have to give the values to the program. Okay, that is, the program should accept the values from the user. Okay, so that here instead of giving values, constant values like a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, we may specify it in scanf function. Okay, for that accepting input from the user, we are using a function called as scanf. Scanf function. Okay, scanf. Scanf function. Okay, so in scanf function, if you specify the values which were given in a and b, okay, instead of giving values directly to a and b, we can specify it in scanf function. Okay, the scanf function is getting the value. The scanf function help us to get the values from the user. Okay, so scanf percent d. Okay, already I told you that why we are specifying percent d, because it is a numeric value. We are accepting the numeric value. We want to get the numeric value from the user, so that we are specifying percent d. Okay, within quotes, comma. So to get the value, we have to specify ampersand a and ampersand b. Okay, so here instead of giving values directly to the variable, we ask the user to enter the value. Instead of giving values directly to the variable, we ask users to enter the value. So we have to get the values from the user, so that we are specifying scanf function. Okay, now we have specified int a comma b comma c. The same thing we have specified, but instead of assigning values to the variable, just we have specified variables a, b, c. Okay, so here the same thing, the same statements are given. Else statements have not altered. C is equal to a plus b, and same thing is going to be carried out. Printf for printing the value, printing the result. We are using the addition of two numbers, percent d, c. Okay, so this value is going to be given, and if this program or these statements are executed, and the compiler, that is the system, will ask the user to enter the value. Now when we compile, okay, you save the program, you compile the program, and the user will ask you to enter the a value. If you enter a value 15, again it will ask you to enter the b value 15. Now what is the c value? It will print the c value as 30. Okay. So first time it will print the C value as 30. Okay. Once again, you compile and you run the program, and it will again ask the user to enter the value. It will again ask the user to enter the value. Now the user can give the different value. Okay. Whereas in the first program, only the values are assigned for the variable A and B. So how many times, okay, if we execute, then we will get the same values. There is no difference in the result. Okay. Whereas when we use scanf function to get the value from the user, then user may give different values and we will get the different results. Okay. So in this way, we may write the addition of two numbers based upon C language. I think you people are understand how to write addition of two numbers. Okay, likewise, if you want to add addition of three numbers, you may add instead of A, B, C, you may give, you declare another variable like D, okay, and you store the result in D, you add A plus B plus C, okay, and you print, instead of C, you print D. Okay, here instead of A, B accepting ampersand A and ampersand B, and you may accept ampersand C. Okay, so in this way we may increase addition of two numbers. If we increase many numbers for addition of our program. Okay, for that we may write addition of n numbers. How to write addition of n numbers? Okay, it may be discussed in next section. Okay, thanks for your patient listening. Thank you, guys.